Get ready to match the stars. Bill Daly, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Ethel Merman, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Fly. As we play the star-studded big money match game 75. And now here's the star of match game 75, Gene Rivers.
Are you ready? Okay, we are ready. Listen, I forgot to say the last time we were together that he's with Bob What's-His-Name show. He's one of the stars of the Bob Newhart show there.
There he is.
Yeah. Wonderful.
This fellow
here. Can I applaud myself for
Bill,
that?
Bill What's-His-Name. Yeah. Sure. You know, you're really marvelous in that show.
Thank you.
Everybody in that show is good.
Specials for children that are marvelous called Bill Daly's Hocus Pocus Show, and they're a delight.
Thank you.
Right.
Yes. Thank you.
Now, $3, please.
This, I've never seen those. Where do they play in syndication?
Yeah, they're in syndication. They're in about 150
Tijuana.
Markets. Tijuana.
Oh, I see, yeah. All right.
Guadalajara. They're in the same markets at Masquerade Party or something.
Right after the religious sign-offs. They come about 1:15 in the morning. It's kind of hard to get them.
All right, if you're ready, we'll have a go at it. And let's say hello to these two charming ladies here, Sonny Hodges and Maggie Moore. Hello, ladies. How are you?
Fine.
Sonny is our current champ, as you know. She won $6,300. Have you spent that in your head yet?
No.
No? You have any idea? I mean, here's $6,300. What are you going to do with it?
I'm going to see my sister. Go visit my sister.
Where does she live?
In Japan.
Oh, well. Here's $7,000. Maggie Moore's had her first round question. I beg your pardon.
I say funny, she doesn't look Japanese.
No, she doesn't. Maggie Moore's had her first round question and matched three of our celebrities, which is kind of unusual for a first rounder. Usually, you know, they're a little tougher than that. You did very well. And your question is going to come along in a minute or so. But right now, we're going to pass along this message of interest to you. So I ask you to pay, please. Here we go. Now, Sonny, this is all yours. Listen carefully. Everybody plays. Harvey's psychiatrist charges him double because Harvey has two blanks.
Yes.
Harvey's psychiatrist charges him double because Harvey has two blanks.
Just let me check. Here.
Do I get something for doing it? For getting that in ahead of everybody?
No, I'm just
it's my show, Brett.
Oh, but
if anybody's going to check him, it's going to be me.
Oh, okay. Anything you say. See you in Encino.
All right. That doesn't change a thing. Here we go, Sonny Hodges. Harvey's psychiatrist charges him double because Harvey has two blanks.
I hope he's a Siamese twins. I said bodies.
Has two
bodies.
Bodies. Yeah. She said, I hope he's a Siamese Siamese twin. He has two bodies.
They're turning on her right away.
That's right.
I'm afraid of my answer.
Yes. What do you say?
They beat you up after the show if you're wrong. Blah, blah, blah. But I mean, I think we're really kind of together on that because this got to be, I said heads, two heads.
Two heads?
Does that mean we're together?
No.
No.
A Siamese twin has, you know, one head and two bodies or various parts. What do you say there?
Didn't Bill give a terrific answer?
Yeah, very good
Thank
answer.
You, boy.
That's a marvelous answer.
That's Thank really you. A
thing. No match, but a marvelous answer.
I said heads.
Say, yeah. See, Sonny, psychiatrist deals with head problems, emotional problems, which are in your head mostly. What do you say, Charles?
I said two personalities.
Two personalities. All right. Harvey's psychiatrist charges him double because Harvey has two heads, according to Sonny.
Well, I didn't think about two bodies, but I did say two heads.
We got a lot of heads here, but no bodies, Sonny. What do you say, Rich?
I was going to say tails, but I said head.
All right. Miss Weirdo of 1975.
There you
go. Oh, no.
This is Kathy Cassie.
Sure. Listen, I'm on display in a toy store later.
Now, here's what I have to say. Not having experience with psychiatrics, but my friend Brett, whoops, that many people go because they're two-faced. I said they're two-faced.
Two-faced.
Didn't match either, did it?
No, it didn't. I must say, that really is very attractive. If you don't have color television, why, you may not be aware of the fact that it looks like a bed quilt. And it's...
Tell him what he said.
I didn't say that.
No, but someone said... Someone said... Everybody do it. Yeah.
I just took you off my bed this morning. It really does look like a quilted bedspread. Looks like a quilted bedspread, but it's very pretty.
It is a quilted bedspread.
Oh, it is. All right. Now we go to round two, Maggie Moore.
A, please.
A it is. You matched three celebrities last time. Matched Ethel, Richard, and
Chuck.
Chuck. I beg your pardon.
Chuck.
Yeah, okay. Chuck in the pink sweater. Yes. Now the rest of you do this. Tiny Tom Thumb said...
It's dangerous. It's dangerous being a tiny person. Yesterday, my Uncle Jack was trampled by stampeding blanks. My Uncle Jack was trampled by stampeding blanks. See, it's Tiny Tom Thumb speaking.
I like your Bela Lugosi imitation better. But that's not bad for a woman your age. I mean,
okay.
We don't write.
You don't write. Oh, you got one.
I hope nobody can
whisper
see
in my
Charles
ear?
Nelson Reilly.
Come over here where there's no microphone. All right. Very good. Very good. She got the idea, finally, and she's not playing. All right. Maggie Moore. Tiny Tom Thumb said, it's dangerous being a tiny person. Yesterday, my Uncle Jack was trampled by stampeding blacks. The blanks. What's that?
Ants.
Ants is her answer. Now, Bill, Brett, and Fanny are the three who play.
Oh, wow.
My Uncle Jack was trampled by stampeding ants, according to her.
I had ants, didn't I really? Yeah. Oh, I should have kept with that. Can I get that out of the hole?
No, you can't.
No, I'm sorry.
You threw it away.
I blew it. I threw my ants away. Oh, well, I had the stampeding thumbs. See, I don't know what that means, but stampeding thumbs?
Thumbs. Listen. Yeah. All together. Okay.
Kool-Aid. Is Kool-Aid doing anything? Another show. Forget that.
Oh, listen, well, ants. So you had ants and you threw it away. That's too
well,
bad.
Yeah, well, I had ants in my pants. That's why I threw it away.
What are you saying,
you ever
Brett?
Had thumbs in your pants. No. Much more.
Can't say it.
This is only rehearsal, right?
Okay, Brett, you're up.
You know what? He isn't even another pretty face.
But my thumbs are pretty.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. All right, Maggie. I got to tell you, when we walked up there, up those stairs, the other night, she says, ants. That was her answer.
My answer, of course, would have been uncles.
Uncles,
but I
of course.
Yeah. That near.
All right, what is your answer, Fanny?
Well, I don't know. I said insects, and I drew ants on it.
Wait a minute.
No, that's all right.
Is that an ant?
An ant.
An ant.
Is that an ant,
that's
folks?
Your basic ant.
No. Can't do that, huh? I tell you, it looks more like an arachnid to me. Sorry about that. Now, so you've got four, and your question is yet to come, Sonny, and that'll be our second and final round question for you, and you're going to have to go some, but right now we got to go some and catch up with this mess. We are ready. Here we go. Second and final round, Sonny. This is it. You must match four to stay in the game. Five will win another game for you. King Kong said...
Oh, yeah!
I never should have eaten that peanut butter. Now I've got a blank stuck to the roof of my mouth. That's what King Kong said.
I never should have eaten that.
I got mine first. Do I get anything?
No.
Get a free salami that glows in the dark. Yes. I get the star.
Yes, the star.
Matt, write your answer and leave him alone.
I can't think of an answer. Charles.
You must.
Think of a question.
Tracy, now I've got...
I never should have eaten that peanut butter. Now I've got a blank stuck to the roof of my mouth. You know, when you eat peanut butter, it sticks to the roof of your mouth.
The old elephant joke?
And then something else that you might get into your mouth would get stuck to the peanut butter. See, that's the whole idea of the question. I've given you three ways now, Brett.
Okay, hon.
Okay.
Writing a letter home.
All right, everybody is ready, and we'll call on Sonny Hodges. Sonny, King Kong said I never should have eaten that peanut butter. Now I've got a blank stuck to the roof of my mouth. Have you ever seen that picture with King Kong? Reruns in the late show?
Yeah.
Oh, you have. Okay, then you know what we're talking about.
One more time, could you repeat it? Now I've got a...
Sure. King Kong said, I never should have eaten that peanut butter. Now I've got a blank stuck to the roof of my mouth.
Banana.
What?
Banana. You're making her feel bad.
Yes.
She's won $6,300. That'll make her feel good. Bill, she said she got a banana stuck to the roof of his mouth. There,
his mouth. Yeah.
Her mouth.
Well, I had, I always get this upside down. I had, Faye Ray. Remember her? A girl stuck to
a girl, yeah.
They like that one. The first one.
That's right.
Thank you,
by Jove, I think he's got it. Has he got it?
Got what?
The idea, the whole thing.
The idea.
All right, Brett. What do you say?
Now, this answer may seem odd to a lot of people, and I have no intention of explaining it. He got a loaf of bread stuck to
peanut butter?
You said what goes with peanut butter, didn't you?
All right. Okay. Charles?
I have what I think is an adorable answer.
Ha!
Volkswagen.
A Volkswagen. Here's Maggie Moore wins the game. What are the rest of you out there? She's here in the building playing. That's it. We got it. Come on, Maggie. Congratulations. Okay, you stand by for a moment now. Sonny, you see, King Kong was an enormous fellow.
I know.
He would open his mouth, an airplane would fly in, whatever they had. You had airplane. Yeah, a whole building would fly in his mouth.
The Empire State
anyway.
Building.
That was the idea.
Still had a ball.
Well, you did have a ball, and you had $6,300,
right,
Sonny.
Right.
What are you going to do with that money?
I'll visit my sister.
In Japan.
Right.
Okay, bon voyage to Sonny Hodges. All right. Here we go, Maggie Moore. Ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Maggie, we had a bunch in here one day, studio audience, and we put it to them. We got this question we asked them, and we got their response to this. Blank Joe. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500, then $250, and $100. Now, whom do you call on for a little assist?
Richard.
What do you say, Richard?
It's a toy that children play with, G.I. Joe.
G.I. Joe, okay.
Charles.
Charles, have you got one?
I got one. Set him up.
Set him up, Joe.
Right.
Okay, that's two.
Ethel.
Ethel.
I'd say Old Black Joe.
Old Black Joe. All right.
Now, all together. Lights here,
nothing to hit but the heights. Okay.
Save it.
So, it's... Old Black Joe, G.I. Joe, and Set 'Em Up Joe.
G.I. Joe.
You want to say that one? G.I. Joe. Okay, that's the one we're looking for. Maggie, of course, hopes it's under the $500 response, but we're going to start at the bottom as usual and reveal, if you would please, the $100 response. Little Joe. Little Joe was a comic strip character, wasn't he?
No, he was in...
On Bonanza.
Bonanza.
Oh, on Bonanza. Yeah, he was one of the Cartwrights. Yeah. Well, he was on this show, wasn't he?
I was just going to say he was even on this show, but I didn't want to embarrass him.
How soon they forget. All right. We are looking for G.I. Joe. Here's a $250 response. Sloppy Joe. Celebrities are doing great, aren't they, audience? Okay, last chance for G.I. Joe, Maggie. Here's the $500 response. G.I. Joe. Now, Maggie, you're up to $600.
Yeah.
And that means you're going to go at $5,000 now. Remember, to collect that amount, you must match one of our celebrities. Has to be an exact match. Time to choose one.
Oh, Richard.
Okay.
Don't get emotionally involved now.
Just because he's a better kisser. Okay, here we go. For $5,000 now. Listen carefully. Blank jerk. J-E-R-K. Blank jerk. Okay, he's finished. Now, Maggie, what answer would you like to give us which you think will match Richard? Blank jerk.
Oh, I'm just blank.
I said that.
Literally.
I said blank jerk, you see. Now you have to say something else. Blank jerk.
For some reason, up jerk?
Well, I guess she drew a blank. Now, that happens occasionally on this game.
That's a good answer. She works for the airline. She's a flying assistant. Every time she gets in the plane with the pilot, she says, up, jerk. Yes.
Okay. Now, listen. Audience, aren't you going to be surprised when Richard holds up his card and it says, up, jerk? Aren't you going to be surprised now? All right, watch this.
Can we have a roll of drums?
Now, wait a minute. Can we have a roll of drums, please? Where's the drummer? Would you roll the drums, will you?
I'm sorry before we go any further.
What? You mean it's not going to be up, jerk?
It was an excellent joke that Charles said.
Yes.
A little costly at $5,000. Soda jerk.
Soda jerk! You know... I was trying to give it to you through mental telepathy. Because it's the only thing I could think of. Is there any other than soda jerk?
Yes.
What?
We all have.
There are, just what else fun? Besides soda jerk?
Well, soda jerk, everybody. I guess that's the only one. Big jerk, yeah.
Big jerk, old well, jerk, new jerk.
Maggie Moore, you got the $600. Going to play another game after this commercial message, and you might win again. Who knows? So come right back, friend. Now we're going to start another game, and we're going to get right to it. And our new player is Ron Valenti. We welcome you. We're going to find out about you as we go along. But we want to get a question in. So I'll push this button and ask you to make a selection, Ron.
How about B?
You want B? All right, here we go. Everybody plays. In Kentucky, it is not unheard of for a man to marry a chicken. Divorces, however, are less common because the only way a man can divorce his chicken is to blank her. All right. Okay. You learn something every day on this show, don't you? In Kentucky, it is not unheard of for a man to marry a chicken. Divorces, however, are less common because the only way a man can divorce his chicken is to blank her. Now, don't think about it too long.
But I can't.
Because you're going to strain something. Chicken. Kentucky, you see. You're down there in Kentucky. That's it. You got it. Lay it in there.
Once
all right.
More.
Here we go. You've got it. You've got to climb it. Forget it. Ron Valenti. In Kentucky, it is not unheard of for a man to marry a chicken. I bet you didn't know that, did you? Until today, we didn't know it either. Divorces, however, are less common because the only way a man can divorce his chicken is to blank her.
Fry.
Fry her. He said, Kentucky fried chicken. Fry her. What do you say, Bill?
Oh, well. Well, I just was engaged to a chicken once, and...
Yeah.
But we never got around this. She was a little stuffy, but I think pluck her would be kind of it.
Pluck would be the word. All right. That's one answer. Not a bad choice there. Brett?
Honey, we thought we all had it this time. A pluck.
Really? Well, I think his answer is marvelous. I mean,
pluck.
Pluck is good, but I think fry is better. Ethel, show him a good answer.
I guess it means the same. I said cooker.
How about cook and fry? There's a match, Ron. Richard?
Probably I have a match as well. Pluck?
Yeah. No.
I just tried for you, Ron.
Are you offering him a little Kentucky fried chicken?
Hi, Brad. Eyes.
Bye. Bye. Bye.
Two for you. It was a good answer. They were wrong, Ron.
I mean, so.
Okay, now, we've got a first-round question for you, but not now. Right now, we've got this for you, dear friends. We don't have time for any more game, but we do have time to hear the story of Ron Valenti's life in 8 seconds, Ron. Tell us where you're from and all that.
Well, I'm a high school instructor. I teach physical education at Bakersfield.
At Bakersville?
In Bakersfield.
Bakersfield?
Yes, sir.
Oh, physical ed. Yes, you're head of the department and all that.
No, I'm not.
Yeah. Are you married?
Yes, I am. I have a lovely wife, Linda.
She's here?
Yes, she is.
All right. Well, it's nice to have you with us, Ron, and we'll look forward to seeing both of you next time. Until next time, this is Gene Rayburn for Match Game 75. Goodbye!
Bill Cotman production.